गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द रीडिंग ऑफ द चैप्टर लेटर टू गॉड. द हाउस द ओनली वन इन द एंटायर वैली. आई हैव रिटन द वर्ड मीनिंग साइड बाय साइड एंड अंडरलाइन द वर्ड्स. यू आर सपोज टू राइट दिस वर्ड मीनिंग्स इन योर नोटबुक. इट वॉज द ओनली हाउस इन द एंटायर वैली. द होल एरिया विच इज सराउंडेड बाय द लोअर लैंड सराउंडेड बाय द हिल्स इज नोन एज द वैली. सेट ऑन द क्रेस्ट on the top of the hill or the low hill. From this height one could see the river and the field of ripe corn dotted, that is spread out here with the flowers because the crop was ready, that always promised a good harvest. It's in a very good way. The only thing the earth needed was a downpour. It was required, rain was required, or at least a shower throughout the morning. Lencho is the main character who knew his fields intimately, very closely, had done nothing else but see the sky towards the northeast. He was waiting because the sky was covered with the clouds. He was waiting for the downpour. Now we are really going to get some water, woman. He was talking to his wife. My dear lady, very soon there will be some water when it will rain. The woman who was preparing supper. Supper is the last meal of the day. Evening meal, dinner you called, replied, yes, God willing. If God wills, everything will happen. The older boys were working in the field while the smaller ones were playing near the house until the woman called to them all. Now they were all to have their dinner. So the elder one, they were outside working in the fields. The younger one was playing near about. The woman called them all, come for dinner. It was during the meal, when they were having their dinner during the meal, that just as then, what happened? It started rain. So just as then, Lencho had predicted. As Lencho had predicted means forecasted, announced, big drops of rain began to fall. Immediately it started rain. In the northeast, huge mountains of clouds could be seen approaching. Approaching means the clouds were coming very near. The air was fresh and sweet. The man went out for no other reason than to have a pleasure of feeling the rain. He wanted to enjoy the rainfall. So he went out without any other reason. And when he returned, and when he came back to the house, he exclaimed, these aren't raindrops falling from the sky. They are new coins. It's a different type of rain was there. The big drops are 10 cent. You can see this cent is currency in the coins. It's the size of raindrops were like that. And the little ones are fives. With a satisfied expression, contented mind, he was happy with what the can say the crop will be. He is happy very much. He regarded the field of ripe corn with the flowers dabbled in curtain of rain. Now the field which was ready with the corn, with the wheat flowers, and it was dabbled. It was totally covered with the rain, but suddenly a storm wind began to blow. Immediately the rain converted into a storm, and along with the rain were large hailstorm, which you can say hailstorm. Snow began to fall. These truly did resemble new silver coins. This type of rain was something different, something new, like the silver coins. The boys exposing themselves to the rain, the boys also came out, ran out to collect the frozen pearls. Frozen pearls means the icy hailstorm, which you people call Ola Girna. It's really getting bad now because the storm changed into disastrous calamity, exclaimed the man. I hope it passes quickly. May God, it doesn't make any destruction. It did not pass quickly, but it never happened. After an hour, the hail rained on the house. The house was also covered with the hailstorms. The garden, the hillside, the cornfield, on the whole valley, the field was white. Everywhere you can see the whiteness of the snow, as if covered with the salt. Not a leaf remained on the trees. Everything covered white. The corn was totally destroyed. Leaves shattered from the trees. the crop shattered, destroyed. The flowers were gone from the plants. In the strong wind, Lencho's soul was filled with sadness. He too became sad because he was expecting such a great crop now this year. When the storm had passed, he stood in the middle of the field. When it calmed down, the storm calmed down, he was standing in the middle of the field and said to his sons, "It is the condition like what? A plague of locusts would have left more than this. If it was an attack, a plague of means attack of the insects which you can flies. Now you people are listening nowadays, TD attack, what you can say. So it must have left something behind for the farmer, but this hailstorm left nothing for the farmer and the family. The hail has left nothing. This year we have no corn, no crop. That night was a sorrowful one. All our work for nothing. All the labor has gone to a waste, nothing else. There is no one who can help us. Oh, we all go hungry this year. We'll have to starve. Without crops, without our fields, we are not going to get anything throughout the year." So what did Lencho hope for? Lencho hope for a huge or a great crop this year. What did Lencho say? The raindrops were like new coins because it was in the rain was falling in a very different way. How did the rain change? The rain changed into the hailstorms. And what happened to Lencho's field? Everything was destroyed. What were Lencho's feeling when the hail stopped? That everything has destroyed and they will starve throughout the year this time because nobody is there to help them at all. But in the hearts of all who lived in that solitary house in the middle of the valley, there was a single hope in the heart of everyone. In the heart of that family, there was the same hope, the only hope, and that was help from God. Don't be so upset. Even though this seems like a total loss, remember, no one dies of hunger. That's what they say, no one dies of hunger. Now the wife was trying to convince that don't worry so much. If the God has given the life, the God will definitely give the food. No one is going to die because of the hunger. All through the night, Lencho thought only of his own one hope, and that was the help of God, whose eyes, as he had been instructed, he has been directed, he has been taught, as we say to our children, to you all, that God is watching everything. He knows everything. He knows the reality. So he also knows that he sees everything, even what is deep in one's conscience, what is there inside the heart, God knows it. Lencho was an ox of a man. He was so hard working like an animal in the field, but still he knew how to write. He was a laborer, he was a farmer, but still he was literate enough to write the alphabets. He was able to write a letter the following Sunday. The next Sunday at daybreak, in the morning itself, he began to write a letter which he himself would carry to the town. He will go to the city and place it in the mail, in the letter box. It was nothing less than a letter to God. So he wrote a letter to God. He wrote, "If you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year." What he has written in the letter, what was the content of the letter? If God doesn't help me, my whole family is going to starve in this year because we don't have any food or crop with us. I need 100 paisas. Paisas is, which you can say, American currency. In several Latin American countries, the paisas is the currency in order to sow my field. Why he needs the money? To get the seed and sow it again in the fields, and a little bit to purchase from the market to have some food. He began to write, "God," he wrote, "if you don't help me, my family and I will go hungry this year. I need 100 pesos in order to sow my field again and to live until the crop comes, because the hailstorm had destroyed everything."